Games Part 2. So we're just going to continue on, because we can. I'm alone. St. Patrick's Day. Happy St. Patrick's Day to all the Irish people out there. I'm part Irish. Also part Hungarian and German, so...
In the previous episode of Life is Strange...
Keep that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Oh, shit!
He called film Little Pieces
what
of
the
Time.
Fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone! Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
Oh, shit. So, yeah, so happy St. Patrick's Day to everyone out there. And I would be out partying, but one, I'm underage. And two, well, not under 18, but you know what I mean. Yeah, I'm gonna snooze. Don't wake me up, Mom. Why do you have to wake me up? I was just thinking about this, about the, like, the college thing. Sound and shit like that.
Something good. Oh, something good. Oh, something good. Oh, something good tonight. Make me
that is strange. Episode 2, Out of Time. Sorry if the music's very loud. I don't know what would be good enough or what would be bad enough. I don't know if I need to get... Well, I'm gonna get up. Why not? My alarm had to wake me up. What the hell? Where's... Are those chickens? Like little chicks? Chickeny chicks?
Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower.
I need a shower.
It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games.
Mystic enchanted currents. Me at 9:40, I'll be there. Do not be late. Time is not on your side.
Even with all this crazy.
Wait, who else? Mama!
Crazy shit going on. It's so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like, no time has passed.
Plus,
okay, Max, let's hit the showers now.
So, again, sorry about the sound. You know what? Let me fix that right now. Audio. Keep master like that. Music down a bit. Sound effects. Okay, that should be good enough. Timetable. Wait, I didn't see this.
Mrs. Hoyta is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. poor thing.
Miss Hoyet? Who the hell goes by Hoyet?
I do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the
oh shit. It's a go, wow, pow, wow.
Ow!
I hit Warn.
Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Consider it
done. Oh, shit.
Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
How did you know? Oh, women. I know them. Warn. Let's see who else.
Everybody's seen it by now.
Whatever they're watching must be hot stuff.
Must see.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
Uh-oh.
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
No problem.
What about Zachary? Did you let him off the hook?
When he acts like a worm, I let him dangle.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
So I guess no boys allowed. And there's someone there.
Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
You look distracted. Everything cool?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Taylor's room.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual. What's happening, Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch, Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like
fun. To be honest, I've never been...
Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
I've never been to, like... Wait. Contraceptive pills. Oh no, is she pregnant? I can see the belly. Royal Blaze, use. Paper ball.
This is both sad and pathetic.
Logan. Let's go take a shower. Oh, you know what would be dope if the shower's already, like, nice and hot?
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
She seems happier.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? Oh, by the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Eat that, Bradbury!
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Not good for the naked eye.
What's up, Kate?
School. That's it?
That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Huh?
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Well, looks like
better
it.
Better than what you can
I know
do.
Nathan.
Oh, shit.
And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way.
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate or Max.
Gossip.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
But wouldn't it be better if they just sent it to everyone's phone? Like, I'm just a saying. Okay, no towels. You fucking just dripping wet.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book.
Tampon dispenser.
Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot. I need to get dressed before I go there.
You were just there. Like, what the fuck? Max. That's a funny photo. Or drawing. Okay, clothes. Get dressed.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
True. Where's search?
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
Where did she leave a book? Or water the plant. Plant needs life. Nope. Not yet.
And nothing here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book.
Better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
Okay, just saying, if I could rewind time...
Be gone, foul soft drink.
I would love that, just for those moments.
Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
Oh, and then do it for the lottery?
Now I can finally take this back to Kate. Now I have to wonder if any of these films are based on a true story.
Keep calm and carry on. Classic. I still have, like, a stuffy note, so sorry if that's bothering y'all. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything while I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep. Okay!
Oh, shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I'm in serious danger. If I'm not already. Fine, I won't disturb you. Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Oh, shit, I wanted to take that off. She plays violin.
Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her.
Kate, your father and I just received a rather disturbing call from Principal Wells about jury. About you and some party video. Our concerns about sending you to Blackwell seems justified. Please call us after your classes this evening so we can fully discuss this matter. We hope you haven't brought shame on you or our family. We'll pray for you and expect you to pray for forgiveness. Your mother. I wouldn't lie, like...
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
Like, for her being, like, cloth.
Why did she cover up the mirror? Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
Well, now she's postcard tissues.
That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through... I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella.
Aw, buddy! Aw, he's shivering! Poor buddy. Field of view, boy.
Ouch. She left out Amnation.
Dear Katie. Katie. No spirit or devil could have prepared me for what... you have done in that videotape, and like Jezebel, you released your harlot image before God's eyes. I will pray with my church for your soul to be saved from eternal hellfire on Antimarsh. That feels bad for her.
Good Lord. This must be Kate's H.R. Geiger period. Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles.
Now she's going into depression.
Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty.
Bible, Lefant.
Damn, it's the all-American zombie family.
Nah.
It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately. It's way too emo in here. Kate?
Hey, Kate. I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I had no choice. David Madsen is an asshole.
You had the choice to not get involved. Nobody here seems to care about anybody.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
What about this video? And I swear I haven't watched it.
I can't even watch it, Max.
Should I watch it? What? Why would you say that? Okay, I'm gonna say it.
Should I watch it? Just for posterity?
Are you kidding? You know how humiliating this is for me?
No, I can't rewind!
No,
shit!
This sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
Why would you go? Doesn't sound like you.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Are you sure it was just one sip?
I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
How sick were you?
Sick enough to need a doctor. I thought I was dying, Max.
So, Nathan didn't take you to the ER?
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Shit. Wait, what do you want me to... Oh. Book.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Shit! If you go to the police, they'll start questioning him and then he'll get pissed. Or look for proof. Well, you could say you've been raped, and then you need the police. Because what she could do, go to the police, tell her side of the story, and then they'll investigate the school.
Yes, you should definitely go to the police, Kate. I totally believe every word you say. Nathan Prescott is truly dangerous.
Bless you, Max. I will go to the police, and also Principal Wells. With you as my backup witness, they'll have to take us seriously now.
Backup witness? Well, I mean, I believe you in everything, but we're still just spoiled punk students to the cops and faculty. I just... think we need to be very careful here.
Why? Careful of what?
Nothing. Except the Prescotts are a powerful family. I hope this won't backfire on us, that's all. Even though that rich bastard has earned some serious bad karma. He'll get it.
But that please be the right call. Shit.
Time out, Max. You actually told Kate to go to the police and the principal after getting a scary text threat. Now the police will definitely drag you into this shit.
Okay, I'm actually gonna look this up. Choices. I need to know what's the good choice. Okay, important choice number one. Go to the police or look for proof. Choice. Go to the police. Consequence. This is a disappointment. Okay, so we are gonna... We're gonna choose to go to the police. Wait, what? Wait. It would have gone for you to save Kate. Go to the police.
Yes, you should.
Wait, shit. There we go. Because hopefully what she says is that she thinks that it will... Chloe. Food. Two whales. See you there. Don't hurt your fingers sexing. Yay, breakfast. No emoji! Because what I think is that she will say what she thinks, and then she'll bring witnesses, but oh god, fucking Taylor, like, oh my god, bitch.
I don't think I've actually seen Taylor alone.
Hi Taylor.
Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Not
I don't want to fight with you
friends.
Or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
True.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Wait, what the fuck? Okay.
Hi, Taylor. I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm glad we did.
Max, get over here!
Warren, what are you doing here?
Oh, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
Oh, God.
By the way, thank you for stepping in. You were pretty badass, Warren. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
He's dangerous. I don't want you to get involved. You got me there, but lay low. Nathan Prescott is going to get his karma soon.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon.
Yeah, Planet of the Apes.
Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old-school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool. I'll text you the info.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Oh, no.
By the way.
Oh, yeah.
You're a real.
Even though you left.
an old...
I bet you're...
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I was too scared to tell Principal Wells. Please, don't say anything. I'll give you more info later.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia...
No, I don't think I can concentrate on going out to the movies. I just feel like escaping.
Fine. Be a damn dirty human. I'll go eat myself.
Warren, what are you doing?
Wow.
By the way...
Oh.
You're real...
Even though you left...
And...
Wait, praise... I'm busting him.
Weird fuck.
Don't say anything. Good.
Well, that was...
Go take the bus. Oh shit, there's Nathan.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
Earphones or headphones. Why did I say earphones? Who the fuck am I?
Don't you know that I'll be around to guide you through your weakest moments to leave them behind you. Turning sunlight, it'll be alright. Cast some light and it'll be alright for now. Crosses of armor will be on your shoulders. Sirens inside you waiting to step forward. Disturbing silence, darkens your sight. Cast some light and you'll be alright. Cast some light and you'll be alright. Crosses along.
My back kills.
Don't try to take it from me. It's mine.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same.
RV again.
There's that dirty RV from the other day.
Stop that! Stop! No barking.
The dog was nice the other fucking day.
There was something creepy about that guy and his dog.
Can I go around? No, of course. Of course there's gonna be a fucking random ass block over there. Okay, flyers.
Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them.
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
Your own boat? Oh, your own boat. I was about to say,
you did pretty good to have lasted this long.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat. Until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay, if that tells you much.
Do you know them?
Too good for my working kind. I know them through their bad deeds. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
Feed the homeless.
Hello.
Oh, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
And this town?
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
What happened to you?
What didn't happen to me? Sometimes you start out in life turned around the wrong way. I married dumb, made mistakes, got cheated out of my savings, lost my home, and now I hang out here.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless, but Arcadia Bay is still my home.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble? Married to a real prick.
His name is David Madsen.
He told me to get a job once, asshole. Not sure what Joyce sees in him, but he better treat her right.
I have to go now. Goodbye.
Goodbye. How did he not see that? Oh, he might be asleep. Yeah. Image stabilizer.
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
That dude. Fisherman. Oh, there's Trevor.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Hungry.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Whales. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese?
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard she even just got busted with pot in her room.
No big thing.
Is that really a big thing? At least she was chilling in her room.
How do you know she was chilling in her room?
You just said so.
She might have been getting high or getting her spray cans ready or whatever. Yeah, I'd like to think the best of it, but she's now in the Arcadia Bay Police database. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
No, I think she's just had some bad luck.
You have to create your own good luck. I think Chloe would rather destroy. But I'm just a cop, not a psychologist, so...
Well, you do realize that having now
How
a
well
father
do you know Joyce?
Or a
I
different
know her
father,
delicious grub.
It affects his
Everybody
freaking
at the station
mind.
Comes
Simple.
Here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
Uh-oh. I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
Chucka chucka. Some weird dude. Kate Marsh. Love you long time. Flush before pissing on floor.
That graffiti has been here forever.
I some to misbehave.
Gross.
Rachel A. Rachel Amber owes me a BJ. She does your mom. Oh shit. Firewall with me. Firewalk with me. Composed. Kill your base.
Thank you, redneck deck. Poet.
Sucks the dick! Weird lady.
What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails. Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You crack me up, Maxer. Of course I'm baked, so I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up. He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, Max.
Hey, Trevor.
Holla, Max. By the way, I know you saw
oh
me.
Oh my god, his eyes!
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
Yeah, and I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was in there too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway. See you in class, Max.
Whoa, Ken Kesey with Joyce? That's so perfect.
I'm surprised she's working there all by herself. Like, where the hell is everyone else? Like, I've been to a diner before, like...
And there she is. A lovely young woman.
How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But I wish you'd been here to help save Chloe. She got busted yesterday smoking out. Again.
I know. Chloe told me that her stepfather hit her.
I am sorry that was your introduction to David. I hope you get to know him on your terms, not Chloe's. He's a good man, he just...
Yeah, I'm sure he is since you married him, but... Don't be so harsh on Chloe.
It's good you're here. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe? Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, sure. I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair.
Hey, blue hair's
now
good.
Now she's got a rebel.
Blue hair's good.
Stepfather.
I like dyed hair.
I see why. I mean...
Why? What did Chloe tell you?
Well, Chloe texted me that David slapped her yesterday.
He feels awful, and he will be punished. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
That's no excuse to hit a girl. He's an adult.
I don't like it either, Max. David swore it would never happen again. He's true to his word. I just want us to be a family soon. I guess it's all about time.
I think you're right, Joyce.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
Oh, bacon omelet, fuck
yeah.
I was
dreaming about your bacon omelet.
Now finish your coffee.
Dude, I can just imagine a bacon omelet right now.
One bacon omelet for the young lady, stat.
Bacon at 12 o'clock hot.
I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
I do like diners.
Can I get some beer and bacon?
Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here. Not a bar.
No beer?
It looks like you had.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
Bigfoot bacon omelets.
Plenty. Stick with the bacon.
This is like fourth dimensional.
What kind of dive is this?
Incoming.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now.
I can hear your stomach.
But then it wouldn't be a moment.
Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh.
Give me the bacon omelet.
Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
No, you're not. This is my treat. To you, for coming back to rescue my daughter.
Nobody needs to rescue me.
Unless you set your room on fire smoking out.
Oh, God, here it comes. Didn't you and Sergeant Pepper already read me the riot act last night?
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
Damn it.
You guys are still the same. Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Razor blades, skull
keychain. Skull keychain for a punk like you.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, that psychic was so girl. Let me show wrong, you what's actually Max. In my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
Okay, panda keychain. 7 cigarettes. $0.80, $0.86. Parking ticket.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max, I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, wait.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield.
Irish! What else? St. Patrick's Day. Woo!
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86
cents. 86 cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
Cigarettes?
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7.
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time. Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck.
Who the hell says that?
You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops!
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh!
And now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Oh, shit.
That's the best song I've
heard
yet.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Drops
the trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Joyce beats them.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
I think I was wrong about that one. Jukebox crazes a cockroach.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarre, Max.
I think I was wrong about that one.
But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Trevor. Oh, I was right. Could see, maybe?
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, way
really?
To go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. But he's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a psychic to guide you.
Okay, girl wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
You didn't even finish the omelet! It's bacon omelet!
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and boo-doo-doo. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with, too.
I'm answering. Kate Marsh,
Kate.
Baby.
What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument.
That's the RV guy. What the fuck? What do you want, bitch?
this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you, and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be, like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm not in the revolution yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit.
I'm gonna get that drink.
Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Hey. Five bottles. Are you kidding me? Old doll. That is creepy.
Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone.
Wait, so is this a junkyard or is it just like... Yeah. Oh, I bet you this one right there. Oh, yeah. I see a bottle. Gun shells.
Those shells look fresh.
Those are shotgun shells. Syringes.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Hello, bottle number one. 4 more to go. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here.
I'm not gonna lie, that's cool that the boat's there. To play the football. Tom Brady's been here. That's a tether ball.
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth?
Ow, I hit my mic. Ow! It burns the lotion!
This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here.
That paper.
I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
Ooh,
only 3 bottles left.
Fuck you, yes you. America!
Mixtape. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. That kind of hurts. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel.
But it was... I don't know. Could she have the power to rewind time to, like, where it's more... like, back in time and she can know what to do? Washing machine. right.
This is the scariest thing here.
What a fucking shirt. Oh. Gimme.
Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack.
What? Literally.
Wow, sir. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. That dough is the perfect photo op.
That almost looks like it's not real. Is it a ghost? Yeah, it's a ghost. Shit. What's it leading me to? Well, can't go over there. Stump. Set? Wait, what?
It's so quiet and primordial out here.
And I leave. Of clothing.
This was an old school punk shirt.
Definitely Chloe's.
No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk.
One more bottle. Alright, look.
I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
He died in a car accident then.
Where to find bottles? Maybe in an old refrigerator.
True.
Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking. Stupid bottle.
I need something for it to break the wall, or I need to jump on something.
One more bottle to go.
And someone to thank. Keeps my faith. Oh, it's a farm there. There's the truck. Gun shells.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Okay. Instead of putting up an invisible barrier. Each shouldn't live. Birdies! Okay.
I'm sure this is a popular party pit.
Aha! Final bottle.
Voila! Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max.
And we got number 6.
Wait, one more for the road?
You're serious about this?
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger. Slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max.
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet. Old school.
Let's see you take a crack at that rusty barrel.
Sorry, Mr. Barrel, your time has come. Listen to those fat bullet beats! Give me something to shoot, Max.
Aim at that old blue plank here.
I hate old planks.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Ooh,
dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Shoot the
window. I want to see that windshield go down.
Watch out for flying glass!
Wait. Give me a second, I gotta charge my computer. Holla yeah!
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel.
No, I wanted to shoot the bumper.
Dude, I need a target before I
put a real dent in that front bumper.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Jesus, I shot myself! Ugh, I shot myself! Back up!
Stupid gun! Hold on, Chloe.
Ooh, shit. Okay, bumper is a
no-go. Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
Well, holy hell.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay, looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo, Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this, and I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Sister. Oh, shit.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
I'm not gonna shoot.
Come on, girly. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me.
Wowzer. Why?
Chloe's waiting to go for a walk.
What time is it?
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers. Obviously don't get my pot from you, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Is this your bad boy phase?
No, it's my trying to scrounge some quick cash so Rachel and I could get the hell out of here phase. Frank had quick cash, that's all.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I don't know anymore. My brain is so fried from all of this. I need a mental enema.
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed.
You think?
I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Yeah.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Come on, Max!
I can definitely use this bad boy. Total MacGyver.
in and out, no problem.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
I can't even move it an inch. It's not locked.
Shit.
But which wire to cut?
Green. It's always the green.
Max!
Oh, stupid light. No go. Shit.
Get me out of here!
But which wire to cut?
Red.
Now that's the right cable. Yes! I did it! You okay? You saved me again! Crazy! Now we're totally bonded for life. Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like you said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
Chaos theory. I gotta look that up.
I have a little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
Like I would miss it. I have the sweetest outfit.
Chaos theory is a branch of mathematics focused on the behavior of dynamical systems that are highly sensitive and imitational conditions.
Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I do.
I'm not anti-soiree.
You seem anti-fashion, though.
A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Matt.
Really?
Oh. I'm sure the Vortex Club has a dress code. As you can see, I would need your advice on what to wear.
Thanks, Max.
I didn't think you noticed high fashion. Tell you what, I'll put you down on the guest list, and before the party, I can give you some tips.
Cool. Thanks, Courtney.
I'll send you the party info later. Back to the list.
That snow was so insane.
Seriously. Hello, climate
like,
change.
Like, seriously. Well. Poster.
Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that shit with the sext in Victoria.
It's over. Just another Blackwell mini drama.
You mean stupid shit. Man, I just don't get Victoria. What does she want?
Probably for all of us to talk about her. Like now.
Then let's not. You're pretty smart, Max. See you at the game Friday.
Wait, so there's a game, there's a dance? Like, what the fuck?
You can really learn a lot about a school by the weird
best
shit posted
ever,
on the boards.
Best guitarist ever to form kick-ass band to take over the world. Funny. Okay, I'm gonna try to talk to him if not.
Sir?
Ah, hello, Max. Would you like to tell me what you wouldn't yesterday?
There was just a lot going on. With the fire alarm and everything.
Yes, but you were distracted by something else.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy. Our head of security is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
Mr. Madsen already treats everybody here like they're under surveillance.
Wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
You won't tell me the truth about yesterday, but you want to tell me the truth about Mr. Madsen. It sounds more like sour grapes. Excuse me now.
Rude.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
Do you mind if we talk about what happened yesterday with Chloe?
You hit Chloe.
I'm sure she told you why. Did she mention she probably stole one of my guns?
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
Like, I can see when he's set down science, bro.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
Like, I can understand with him, man, that he wanted... Because... She was in a Vortex Club party, wants to know why. So, it's like he's trying to be a security guard, but also like a counselor as well.
Yo, Maxwell Smart. Talk later, cool?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. Nobody does.
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Sure.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. but you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me? I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Not right now. I'll tell you everything as soon as I figure it out.
I'd like to believe that, Max. It just seems like there's a lot of drama around you this week.
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Yes. Uh-huh. Sure, okay. Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll do that.
Shit, I'm overhearing this shit.
I know, that makes sense. Huh? Mm-mm. Seriously, I have to hang up now. Let's talk about this later. We'll talk later, okay? I have to go. Because I can't have this conversation with you right now, okay? Would you please just hang up the phone?
Who the hell is he talking to?
Mm-hmm. Huh? Yes.
I just get him right up in his face.
Uh-huh. Sure, okay.
Think.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science. Can't be that hard.
Hey, Warren.
Max.
Asking me.
Have to add
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science. Yes! That was a blast! But let's keep it a professional secret. Cool?
Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max.
Oh, well,
it's too bad
you
didn't sign the petition. Every signature counts, and yours might be the one that decided.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are no dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
Neither. Unless you want a face full of powder, I would add chlorine.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Wait, what the fuck did just happen?
Hey, Warren. Asking me.
Have to add.
Chlorine.
Wrong, Warren. You need to add chlorine, not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it.
What?
Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
What?
That was fun helping Warren.
Brain on Max. You might be the next Heisenberg of Blackwell.
Excuse me, Max. That's no... Of course not.
My word...
Always... And Max? I assume you...
Kate?
What...
Yes, I talked to her on the phone. She need...
Rachel Lamb?
With all...
Rachel...
Not right now. I'll tell you
I'd like to believe that.
Look...
Let's listen to this.
Uh-huh. Sure, okay.
Sure, okay.
Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll do that.
Felice yelling.
Oh, I know. That makes sense. Huh? Mm-mm. Seriously, I have to hang up now. Let's talk about this later.
Whoever he's talking
to. Later, okay, I have to go. Because I can't have this conversation with you right now, okay? Would you please just hang up the phone? Okay.
Someone's desperate for it.
Huh? Yes.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Vogue.
Dana, you are out of control. Turn left, then right. Show me the love.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
You look like ass.
What's up, Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on. I hope you like the sketch I did of you yesterday.
Love. And it's my new avatar.
Excellent. I got tons of likes on FB. Ah, made you blush.
Shut up.
Someday your portrait may hang in the Daniel de Costa wing of the Louvre. We'll talk about it later.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
I knew I should have taken that picture of... what's his name? Oh shit, Nathan.
No time to talk, Max.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal. Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a shit.
Like anybody does. Max, here comes the mysterious Max, disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws. I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Fucking ha ha.
Assholes. Got a problem? Wanna fucking go, bitch?
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down. We have a lot to cover today and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out off.
What's your problem?
All over the world for people to judge.
Too late to rewind.
Usually, people need something to judge, so they never take a good look at themselves.
I guess Kate will miss class now. Reality TV for some of that. I'm worried about her.
We can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example. Who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in my...
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated.
Too late.
Dismissed.
See that? Is this for real?
It flipped out!
I didn't think
think she was that messed up.
Are they really videotaping it?
Kate! No! Oh, God. She can't die. She can't. Not again. Not now.
Whoa!
I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
Oh shit, I paused time.
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
There's a lot of people watching. And I'll be right back, because my dog, of course, has to ruin me during my recording. I'll be back. And I am back. I'm sorry, but that makes me sad right there with the suicide. Yeah, you're too late. Thing here is that I had a friend of mine who passed away because she was getting bullied on Facebook.
Yes.
And she committed suicide. And it's pretty sad going through it, because she helped me through the death of, well, my dad and shit like that, and here we go. Oh, shit, bleeding more. Wait, so is her bleeding nose more natural?
What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me! I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
Don't worry, Kate. Things will get better.
Oh, no, I have to pick I what's
promise.
Better to say.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours. And we can get through this together. Let me help. Like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
I'll always be here for you, Kate. My new motto is, friends come first.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
Are you serious? Thank you so much. The fact that you don't care about that video and would come up here to stop me means a lot.
Of course. Like I said this morning, I think Nathan is involved. I just need time to prove it. And I have a way with time.
You sound so persuasive, Max. If only.
Kate, I believe you. Will you believe me?
Please, you don't have to do this. Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Yes.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No! Nobody cares about me!
What the fuck?
Nobody!
Oh shit, now I have to... Your mother, your father, your brothers, your sisters. Oh my god, what do I say? What do I say? Oh my god. Do I do sisters? Because her mom wrote her the letter, and then so did her aunt. Sisters. I'm going with sisters. Please!
I saw that cute photo of you with your sisters in your room this morning. I can see how much your little sister loves you by her smile.
That's Lynn. She's only 10. She does have the best smile ever. I would hate to see her sad.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, do it! Yes!
Woo! I'm sorry. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Aw. Saving lives left and right. Oh, shit.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody, but I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not. And that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
Nathan dosed her, David bullied her, Jefferson made her cry. Oh, shit! Oh my god, what do I say? I'm going to the internet! Fuck it. I will find what to say. Okay, so this is episode 2. Go to history. Okay. Max suspended Nathan. Last important choice can be found in the last chapter of this episode. In the final moments of it, to be more specific, you'll have to point the one who you think is responsible for the whole suicide attempt. The choice has no consequences in this episode. No action. So, if no action, David on leave, Nathan suspended, blame Jefferson. Sorry, I just texted my sister what I want to eat.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and playing the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit! Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girls' bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast! I already have a personal lawyer.
Wait, Max. You told me that nothing happened yesterday. Are you just making things up? How can I trust you?
I was afraid yesterday, but I have to tell the truth.
I do understand that. And since Mr. Prescott does appear prominently in the video and was responsible for the party, I have no choice but to suspend him until further notice.
Whatever. See you in court.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now.
I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
I don't know what to say. Hold on, this is the next back. And if you admitted that you smoked pot. Not male, Victoria. A webpage will be created to support Jefferson. Jefferson will mention that if he cannot go to San Francisco and the winner of the conference, David will be involved in the chase. Oh, yeah.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out, hugs, tears, applause. Like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it?
Just one. And a half times.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
Aww.
I believe you, Warren. I believe anything this week.
Shit. The apocalypse is coming. Now I bleed down those two. Something's over those two together. So you told Kate to go to the police. Wow. More people want to prove. You answered Kate's call. You didn't try to shoot Frank while most people try to shoot. Save Kate's life. And we blamed Nathan. I hid the truth. I confronted Victoria. Oh, wait, no, that was. It didn't say for me to water the plant. shift. And that's the end of episode 2, and wow, it's nighttime. Cool. But anyway, that's the end of episode 2 of Life is Strange. If you enjoyed this live stream, this video, whatever you can call it, please hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, and go check out my other videos. I'll see you guys tomorrow, maybe. Peace.